Namaste everyone, annyeonghaseyo, Yorobin. A warm welcome to everyone. I am Shweta Chaudhary Khatri, your host for today. After the grand launch of Speak Makay Korea chapter and the immense success of the concert by Pandit Vishwa Mohan Bhatji yesterday, we Speak Makay Korea team welcome you to yet another magical and mystical evening, where we'll all witness and sink in the musical world with our esteemed artist, Ustad Fayez Wasifuddin Dagarji. I welcome you all. We, Speak Makay, believe that in these challenging and rather stressful times, music and art are the forces that can bind us all together and be hopeful for a better tomorrow. With a small prayer, I would like to begin today's function. Shuklam Bharadharam Vishnu, Shashi Varnam Chaturbhujam, Prasanna Vadhanam Dhyaye, Sarva Vigno Pashantihi. Remembering Lord Vishnu and praying for everyone's safety, I would like to begin day two of the Mystic Music Series by Speak Makay, Society for the Promotion of Indian Cultural, Classical Music and Culture Amongst Youth, which is brought to you in association with Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center, the Embassy of India Seoul. SVCC has been providing a platform to showcase India's rich cultural heritage and serve as a nodal point for cultural exchange between India and the Republic of Korea. We extend our heartfelt thank you to the Embassy of India. And also ISRK, a voluntary support group for all students and researchers of Indian origin in Korea, providing educational, research, jobs, social, recreational, and community support. Thank you, ISRK, for your support and help. Today among us, we have Mr. Sachin Satpute, Chairman of Indian Chamber of Commerce in Korea and Senior Vice President and President, Novelis. Mr. Sachin Satpute has been very instrumental in promoting Indian culture and has extended his support and ICCK support to Speak Makay. It is our honor to have you with us, sir. Mr. Sachin Satpute has kindly agreed to address the event today. May I please request you, sir, to please speak a few words.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. Namaste. Annyeonghaseyo. Bangapsamnida. Ustad Wasifuddin Dagar, distinguished guests, and all participants. It is my pleasure and honor to have an opportunity to be a part of this event. I'm Sachin Satpute, Chairman of Indian Chamber of Commerce in Korea, ICCK, which is now 11 years young and has a steadily growing membership base of around 65 members. We help to connect Korean and Indian businesses to explore mutually beneficial opportunities. In addition to the business and trade, we also promote and support cultural activities by closely working with Indian Embassy in Korea. I'm currently working with Novelis as president and business head for Asia Pacific region. Novelis is the world's largest aluminum rolling and recycling company with a global headquarter in Atlanta, US, and Asia Pacific headquarter in Seoul, South Korea. We are very proud to be a part of Indian multinational conglomerate Aditya Birla Group. Novelis is a large investor in Korea, and we have two world-class manufacturing facilities located in Yeongju and Ulsan. I have stayed with my family in Korea totally over 8 years in two stints, and we really enjoy staying in this wonderful country. I would like to extend a warm welcome to all of you. And also, I'm very happy that this music festival event is organized by Speak Makay Korea chapter in association with Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center, Embassy of India, Seoul, and Indian students and researchers in Korea. SPICMAKE, Society for the Promotion of Indian Classical Music and Culture Amongst Youth, has inspired me during my engineering college days 3 decades ago. SPICMAKE, in my mind, is a great movement that inspires youth by increasing awareness about different aspects of Indian heritage and culture. It is over a year now. We all are living through the unprecedented time we encountered with unforeseen pandemic. So the uncertainties prevailed not only in business, but also in our personal lives. Last 1 year reminded us of the value of a normal everyday life, mundane yet important, where we had the freedom to go places and meet our near and dear ones. Events like this not only help to increase cultural awareness, but also help to overcome the COVID-19 pandemic woes by lifting our spirits. So thank you, organizers, and look forward to a wonderful experience. Stay safe and thank you. Kamsa Amnida. Over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Sachin Satpute. Your encouragement really means a lot to us. And thank you for joining us in this cause and promoting the Indian culture. We couldn't relate more to you, the fact that we're all locked in the houses, but events like these indeed brings joy and happiness. Thank you for connecting with us today. We will be having a small interaction session with Ustad Ji post his performance, and we'll be also taking questions from the audience. So if you have any questions or you're curious about his life and events, please feel free to drop your questions on the chat and we'll try to accommodate your questions. It gives me immense honor and joy to introduce you all to the legend himself, Ustad Faiz Wasifuddin Dagarji. Drupad singing is regarded as the most ancient and rigorous form of classical vocal music in India. The term refers to both the musical form as a whole and to one of its 3 parts composed of singing with percussion accompaniment. The other 2 parts are called dhamar, featuring the rhythmic pattern played on the pakavaj, drum, and alap, an unaccompanied vocal style that is free from language and set rhythmic requirements. Ustad Wasifuddin Dagarji is a member of esteemed Dagar family and represents the 20th generation of this unbroken chain of Drupad singers and Veena players. Ustad Ji received his Padma Shri in 2010. Ustad Ji's career began when he gave his first live performance on 25th January 1989, and since then he has performed live concerts globally and mesmerized the world in his fine craft. As Ustad Ji says, and I quote, "My voice resembles my father's. The technique are my uncle's. They are all putting their blessings on me and I'm performing today." He's informal, affable, and has an enviable way with his words. An ability to explain the most esoteric vocal numbers and nuances even to non-singers like me and most of you here. He is very philosophical and in a way not of his age, as he worriedly puts it. हम अपने दौर की खुशियां खरीदते कैसे हमारे जेब में पिछले सदी के सिक्के थे. Ladies and gentlemen, finally the moment we have all gathered here has arrived. Join me in welcoming Padma Shri Ustad Wasifuddin Dagarji. Over to you, Ustad Ji.
Namaskar. I'm really happy to be part of this this concert series, and it's very challenging time, and so nice to hear from our guests who have spoken about this music, about SPICMAKE, and about everything. I'm also very, very happy, or not happy, but I'm at the same time, it's a homage to Pandit Rajan Mishra ji, who passed away, and Pandit Debu Chaudhary ji, who also passed away. So it's to dedicate this program to them, but not only them, the son of Pandit Debu Chaudhary ji, my dear friend Pratik Chaudhary, he also passed away. And one Dhrupad exponent from Malik Gharana, Sanjay Malik, also passed away just a day before. I've never written so many obituaries, no, so many condolences. If I count whatever I've done in this last year, it's a very challenging time. Yeah, this is my favorite couplet, what you have read, that hum apni daur ki khushiyan khareedte kaise, hamari jeb mein pichli sadi ke sikke. With this challenging time, I just change it now. Maybe the poet who has written that, he may not be very happy with this. Hum isi daur mein apni khushiyan khareedenge aise. Hum isi daur mein apni khushiyan khareedenge aise, apni pichli sadi ke sikkon se. To be positive, I just want to go ahead. And it's very important for us to be positive and think that will come out of it. Mard wo kab hai jo bhavar se ubhar sakta nahi. Mard wo kab hai jo bhavar se ubhar sakta nahi. Haki usko haki jeene ka nahi, usko jo mar sakta nahi. So we are in this challenging time, and I'm sure we'll come out of it. So with this positive note, I will sing alab for a little while. This is without the lyrics, without any words, but there is a mool mantra, which is we keep Om as a basic. Om, we feel that is the undivided energy which flows on in each body, all the bodies, and it reflects and it energizes us. Om Anantitam Taranatarnitvam. Om Anantitam, O God, I am in endless darkness. Taranatarnitvam, you please help me to get rid of this darkness. Hari Om Narayan, Ananta Hari Om Narayan. So it starts with Om and it finishes with Om. So we sing rags also, we have techniques also. Akar Kamak Lahek Dagar. It's like the swing, no oscillation. With A sound, Akar Kamak Lahek Dagar Dhuran. If I go on explaining, then it will take little time. Then we have gamaks, when we produce heavy sound with the help of the navel and diaphragm, and then we take it in these are the heavy sound. It's also the percussive variations what you can hear from this also, because body is instrumental in creating all the instrument. So this is the oldest instrument. It is called Gatri Veena, and this body is instrumental in creating so many different instruments. So first is alab, where I have already spoken about it. I have not gone into greater details, but then we have rags. We deal with rags also. So rag is a arc structure of musical note. We have the seven notes in one octave. So in one octave, in ascending and descending order, we have note structures. So that is also called rag. But rag is not just a mere structure of ascending and descending order of our musical notes. Rag has its character, rag has its moods, rag has its favorite notes, which is applied again and again. Less favorite note which is applied. There are few notes which are not there in some particular rags. So then we communicate with that rag. So what does music have? Music have pitch. Music has the musical note. First we have to, if we talk about the music, so then we have the music, the musical note. Then rhythm. So we have rhythm, and it gives the pleasure, it gives us the shanti, it gives us the peace. So for me, it stands like five P's. Pitch for the musical note, pulse, we are not digital people, so our rhythmic pattern or rhythm depends on our pulse rate. pitch pulse pause. Pause is very, because pause is like the silence. Silence is majestic. One should know how to hear the silence. So this also takes you, leads you into spirituality also. It also leads you into meditative modes also. Pitch, pulse, pause. We try to perfect. The practitioners are trying to perfect these things. And the purity stands away like the thumb. It holds everything together. Pitch, pulse, pause, perfection and purity. Sometimes you get into arts because of the purity, and sometimes you achieve that purity much later. So it is there around you. When you want to grip it, then it gives you the grip. It holds you. It is holding you. It is definitely there. It is very much there. So I will start rag Shuddha Sarang. It's a afternoon rag. And sa re ma ve ni sa, so you can say sa re ma, there's no ga, sa re ma ve ni sa, no dha, sa re ma ve ni sa, sa ni da ba ma, pa ma re sa. So there are two ma. Ma, ma, re, sa. So this is in which I will just elaborate as much I can elaborate, and as long I can sing, I will just sing. So with all my ancestors' blessings, all the seniors' blessings, and with your support, I hope we can have a little better time. Yeah.
Re na na.
Rene Nama Nama Rino
Re 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 ma da 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 da
Composition is set in 12 beat time cycle. This is called Chautal. Everybody is hearing it fine, well. So this is Aaj to Badai Bhai Bhavan Bhavan Baj Rahi Maharaja Dasharath Ghar Prakate Sukhda. The celebration, everybody is congratulating each other because Lord Ram is born and he has come to the world as a person who is going to give sukh to everyone. He is going to give pleasure and happiness and peace to each one of us, and everybody is carrying him in his arm and giving blessings and all. Aaj Raja Dasharatha is the father of Lord Ram. Aaj Are don't 12 beats time cycle, another one was in 10 beat time cycle, that is called Sultal. So I'll sing one composition in rag Hindol, though it's not the time of Hindol, but I'm singing. I should sing, or I don't know. So I'll sing. So I've not said what I'm going to sing, and now whatever I'm. So it's just coming. Whatever is coming. So. Ga ga ma de sa da ga Now it's Damar. Larger, So it's about 1 hour of sitting.
For the last hour, I and I'm sure all of us felt that we have time traveled and gone back to receiving Ramji back home. So it was an amazing feeling to experience this. I would say rather a desirable state we would all want to be in forever. And I'm sure many of us agree here that they all time travel to, you know, seeing Lord Ram return Ayodhya. Thank you for performing and thank you for letting us experience this incredible joy and happiness. We are extremely indebted for this experience, Ustadji. Thank you. Ustadji, we all have gone through your life's journey and over the couple of days, we have been researching about you, trying to understand your journey, your life. And we all have developed rather certain curious questions about you. And to put forth those questions, may I request Prathapi and Raman, Sikh Makay Puriya volunteer, to conduct the interaction session. Pallabi and Naman, over to you. Also, just a quick information to our viewers who have joined us. We will also be picking up few questions from our viewers. Feel free to drop in your questions in the chat box. We'll try to answer most of them, but due to the time limitation, we'll try to pick up a few questions from you all. But we have already prepared a couple of questions, which Pallabi and Naman, our volunteers, will put forth to Ustadji to answer. Over to you, Pallabi.
Thank you, Shweta. Namaste, Ustadji. We are all mesmerized. I think most of our viewers would agree. Could you enlighten us how are the various ragas different from each other? What inspires you to play a particular raga in that moment?
Ustadji, you're on mute. Could you unmute yourself, please?
Yeah. It's a big question what you have asked about the ragas. I've misplaced that question actually somewhere. So we have a lot of ragas and rag can be sung in different moods also. Some people have made some moods of particular, some ragas in particular because of the bandish. They feel that this belongs to this mood and this belongs to other mood. But rag can be sung in many different rasas, and because rag is not a mere structure of musical note. For us, rag is the what our ancestors say that rag is the individual personality. So, to personality, if we are communicating, so we are communicating. We are not singing them, but we are communicating with them. When we communicate, so we get inspiration from them, because one conversation is also like that. Hello, how do you do? I'm fine. You are also fine. Thank God, we are fine. But if I want to know you some, if I want to converse more with you, I have to know the nature. So we are taught about the rag's nature and rag's liking and disliking, and then we have our. This is my general explanation. So. For some people it will be a repetition that after knowing a third person because we get the introduction from our guru that this is this rag, this is this personality, and this is how we have to sing, how you have to converse with this. But after we go to the rag with reference of our guru or our elders that they have taught us that this is it. But after meeting 5-10 times, I want that rag should recognize me because of me. And I should recognize rag because of itself. So then we have our own relation with that rag. And then after our relation, then we can converse even more what we've been going through the references. So every rag has, you know, every time it's not set because our pulse rate changes from day to day. From moment to moment. So this is why the song, every time the song doesn't sound the same. The song what we call number these days. So why we don't find, every time whenever we listen to the same song, it doesn't have the same effect. Someday it has a better effect. Sometime you don't know why you're not able to listen to it. It depends on your pulse rate. With what I told you, pitch, pulse, pause, perfection and purity. The pulse rate differs from moment to moment, from person to person, place to place. So then we react accordingly. So 5 minute songs finishes in 5 minutes, sometimes it doesn't finish in 5 minutes. Sometimes it finishes before 5 minutes. This is the state of your mind and this is your pulse rate. And this is how we get connected with that rag at that time. So I had thought of singing some other rag, but it just after singing Shuddh Sarang, I was just searching that what shall I sing another one. So it's not preset. Our musical notes could be the same. If we'll sing the same thing, if we'll have the same conversation, it will be boring for you also and boring for me also. So we go for with the references and we find something new. So this is called Nitnaya, ever new. So it's just like the sunrise or the sunset. Nobody says that I don't want to see the sunset or sunrise. It's so boring, I have not seen. So for rag, rag are ever new for us. It's just the sunrise or the sunset. We get inspiration, we get touched by it. So it's something, you know, it is debatable. What is more important? The touch or the feel of touch? Of course, feel of touch is far superior. We get touched by the nature, which is far away. We can't even think of touching it, but we get touched by it. So we get touched by the rags. Emotions also. We are not particularly touching it, physically touching it. We are getting touched by the text. We are getting touched by the poetry. We are getting touched by the song. So this is what is the inspirational path, how we get into the rag. And there are many rags. There are some 200 rags, 120 prachalit rag, a prachalit rag, and if we go with the permutation combination, there are more than, you can create more than 3 lakhs rag, or with this things, 700 rags, the people say 700. So it's debatable that whatever, however you want to sing. But if you can sing few rags properly, it's, I think we can please our forefathers, our gurus, and beyond them, the Paramatma, the unseen energies, which is watching all of us. So through music we are trying to worship, or we are trying to praise, or we are trying to dedicate our breath to it. You got my reply? Are you happy?
Yeah. Absolutely. Yes, I need to know about your journey and how things appear to you. May I request Naman to take forward the next question?
Thank you, Ustadji. It was a delight to learn about the raga you played. Ustadji, we all have favorites. Which is your favorite raga? Something that you could play any time at any phase of the day. Thank you.
It changes also from months to months, times to time, year to year. So it changes, you know. So my favorite rag remains Bihag. I love Bihag, and I love Soni also. Soni, I have got to admire this rag through my rendering of my father and uncle. I still remember. I love Chandrakos. Now the list will increase, you know. I love this Chandrakos. I heard the Jugalbandi of my uncle Ustad Aminuddin Dagar Sahab and Zia Mohiuddin Dagar Sahab on Bean. So ever since, it has hit me. The musical note hits, but it doesn't hurt. If it hurts, it's not music. So you get hit by a note. So it's just the same hand, you know, you're using pit and pat. Which you are hitting, hit and pat. So you are using the same hand, but how you're using your hand. So I told you I love Bihag, and I don't know which rag. One of my students whenever I start a new rag, I say that I love this rag. So after listening it for I think 10 or 15 rag, 10 rags, she said that every time I hear the same thing, you love this rag, you love this rag. I don't know which rag I love. You know? So this is Rinku Lamba who has said that. You always like it. She's my student, very performing student. So he said that every time, whenever you start a new rag, you say you love this rag. This time I have not said when I started a new rag with her. Any other question? You got the reply? Yeah.
Thank you, Ustadji, for sharing about your favorite raga. The Dagar family has been practicing Drupad genre of music for about 20 generations now. We can tell that the Dagar Gharana truly portrays the history of Indian classical music. So in this century, when people are mostly engaged by commercial music, it's truly inspiring how you are carrying forward the legacy of the Dagarvani with utmost pride and dedication. It makes us as Indians feel proud too. Can you tell us more about Gharana and the Dagarvani tradition?
I am honored to be born in this family, and it's a big pleasure, it's honor for me. And if it is inspiring people and they are feeling proud of our family, so it's a great work of theirs which is being handed over. So when music holds you, you can't leave music. Who are you to leave music, you know? So Drupad has held us, so we are holding it. And this is the big blessing of this art form on us, that we are able to carry on this. So there is one word which is called dedication. Yeah? The thing is, you know, you get hit by a note or you get inspired by something. So you try to achieve that. If you're honest with your own self, you try to achieve that. And you go after that thing, that you want to get that beautiful piece or beautiful musical term or beautiful rag you want to achieve. And when you really get it, so you see some years have gone past. You have to be impatiently patient to achieve the goal, and you have to be impatient of learning more and more. But you should have the impatience and patience when you get it. So time is not fixed. So Dagar family has traveled 500 odd years. So I don't know we are only told that it used to be in Rajwada and all these different like Holkers or in Udaipur. Zakruddin Khan Sahib and Nalabandi Khan Sahib was there in Udaipur. Ziauddin Khan Sahib was also there in Udaipur. Namuddin Khan Sahib was also there in Udaipur. My Nana Tansen Pandeji, he was in Alwar. My great grandfather Nalabandi Khan Sahib was also in Alwar state. So it used to be kept in. All these Maharajas have helped to carry on this tradition, and their job was to just do the music and make new students and disciples so that it can be carried forward. In this modern time, it is challenging that of course you must have heard the people used to sing for 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, but now it is saturated to 40 minutes, you know. So in 40 minutes, you know, what can you present? Means if you see now, it is now people want in 4 minutes the capsules, you know. Capsules are the antibiotics, you know. Antibiotics, you know what, of this capsule you create the capsules to energize for short terms, and an antibiotic for short terms, you know. Okay, it just cures quickly. So, but you should go for the long lasting
medicines. So this is music, is these type of things, and we are trying to keep this. You see, I sang almost for 50 minutes the first round, which is unusual these days. It is getting unusual, but we don't want to sacrifice. This is already a sacrifice to present one rag in just 40 minutes. If I go what I listen from my from the legends and what I listen from my elders, that they used to sing one rag for 1 hour, 2 hours. So it is different, but we are, the life is changing ever since the Homo sapiens are changing, and they are bringing the newness in everything. So this modern age and this COVID era, people must be thinking of Sonic Age, then computer age, that age, stone age, everything. But can anybody have thought of COVID age? We are going through this such a horrible time, but this connectivity, this internet is really helping us to live, to interact, to communicate. Of course, we are at home. Of course, the people at home are more than good enough to live with. But we need others also. We need more people to live for, to live with. So this type of modernity is there, but we should not change ourselves so much that if we watch, we go and see our faces on the mirror, if we are not able to recognize our own self, that will be very, very disheartening and very bad. If we are proud of our culture, if we are proud of our music heritage, so go for modernity, but don't forget your roots. It's not done. So give time. You have to give a time. The most beautiful is that time when you don't think of time. So get into the time and try to merge yourself into whatever you are doing. So even this computer and the mobile phone, when you get into the Facebook and WhatsApp and all these things, time and all, so how much time it takes, isn't it? It's also taking away a lot of time. So sometimes these gadgets are also taking a lot of time, but still we are trying to find the ways. But we should find a way to give priorities to what is being handed over for centuries. People were not mad. We are not reading some new chapters, new theories. We are in colleges and IITs or IIM and all these things. This has been written hundreds of years back, things. What we are reading it now, be it chemistry, be it physics, be it biology, be it history, whatever it is. These are the old greats who have created the subject, and they had given something, and we are studying it. So by studying it or redoing it, we are finding our own path. So research is something which is already been searched. So we are resurfacing it. So if I like to break the word, so I'm again getting into that, re is again search. If I break search also, so it is sea. Every subject is huge, like an ocean, like sea, S-E-A, sea. But sear is to break something. It's a different spelling. But we all these people are breaking the old equations to create the new equations. So it is C and ARC, are arcs. So getting into the sea and finding your own arcs, creating, coming out of, arcs are little curved way. You're getting out of that and you're creating your own arches. Research. So this is research. So get into that. Everybody is so scared of classical, the word classical. Some people like to say classic, but they don't like to say classical. Yeah, there is difference between classic and classical. Yeah. For me, what is classical? or what is classic? The refinement in any subject is a classical act. After knowing something, when you want to know something more, and when you furthermore get into that, so you get into the classical act. So when you go to these IITs and different further studies after 10 plus 2, when you select yourself, your area to expertise. So when you go there, so you're going in further refinement in your selected subject. Oh, that's a classical act. When you're doing plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, whatever, then after doing that, the crash courses are crushing the talent. So when they give you the crash courses also, before the end of the first semester, they say, if you'll go for another one, it will be better for you. And if you'll do another one, it will be better for you. So they say crash courses, but they are not giving you the crash courses also. This is another way. So this is another way of building up the business, you know, of, you know, bringing people and then giving them something, giving them the taste, and then again they are saying, take something. So I used to say, and I still say, my uncle, Sir Zahiruddin Dagar Sahib, he used to give me the taste of the onion. The middle part is the most beautiful, isn't it? There are two ways of getting it. One is to cut, and another way is to, we in India, we break it, we give a fist to it and we break it. And that also you get. But to get the most beautiful part, if you peel it, if you really peel it, and then when you achieve it, so there is a different taste to it. You get the other taste of the onion. That is not only the beautiful or most tastiest part. Other skins, other areas of that beautiful thing are also tasty. So you should get the knowledge like this. You have to, of course. We don't even acknowledge who has put the article on the web. We just download, cut and paste. So that's not right. If your article will be taken from half and will be cut and pasted somewhere else, you will get hurt. So don't do it with others also. So same way in 1 month you can't achieve musical terms or musical knowledge. You have to give a time to it. So give time, then this time is going to give you a beautiful time. If you give time now to music, to your studies, to whatever. So nobody can say we understand everything of computer. And when we say this, the knowledge, all the subjects has been created by human being. But after creating, we have put the knowledge, studies little above us. So we try to achieve it in the higher ways. So the computer is also being created by us. And we say that it's a bit of our brain. That also we say. But do we understand everything of computer? We don't understand. Sometimes it also, this digital, absolute digital thing also shocks us by its replies. When we are sure that it is going to do this, it doesn't do that. Why? So when it comes to these terms, so it is not in your hands. To close one single file, there are three questions: yes, no, cancel. Sometimes it doesn't move with the yes, sometimes it doesn't move with the no, and with cancel also. So what do we have to do? But when it comes to other knowledge, so we feel, oh, it's so boring. With computer, you struggle. No, we have to get out of this problem. Arey bhaiya, just try to give little more time to other studies also, other subjects also. That is going to give you, that is going to help you. That will enhance your knowledge and so on. My replies are too long.
Yeah, enjoying it. That's nothing. Longer than Naman, may I request? We are absolutely enjoying your replies, Ustadji. Naman, may you please ask the next one?
Ustadji, your legacy is a true inspiration. We have seen many of the legendary Dagar Brother concerts. Rudra Veena is played. Rudra Veena is an instrument that is played by very few people that we know of in today's state. I have also read that it is modified by late Ustad Ziyamuddin Dagarji. Does it make any difference when the Rudra Veena is played with Drupad Raga in comparison with any other instruments?
Absolutely, Drupad Veena absolutely goes with Drupad, and it is created by a Dagar, my uncle, and my cousin Bahuddin Dagar. He plays it. My uncle has done a lot of modification from the older version of Veena. And now I had a talk with Bahuddin today itself, and he's helping so many people to make Veena. So he's not only playing it, but he's also showing people how to make Veena, because many instrument makers, they are not going for making this Veena. Like, a lot of people are making Surbahar also, sitar also, sarangi also, tabla also. So Drupadiyas are in minorities, you know. But still we are there. We are trying to. My cousin, our family is putting a lot of efforts to keep the spirit alive of Drupad as well as Veena, and it really goes well with the vocalism of Drupad style. It's different from khayal. So for when you listen to Thumri or khayal, so it goes well with sitar or sarangi. So they are good match for that type of music. And Veena and also Surbahar is a good match for Drupad style of music. So you can hear the wind instrument from the same body, and string instrument also, and percussion also. When I sang the alap, you must have heard the sound of Om. Could you hear that? Instrument, you can never have bigger wind instrument than our lungs, our body. With due respect to all the instruments. लग रहा है झाला लग रहा है अब percussion का भी इसमें variations आते हैं
ट
So I give the example of the damru. लग रहा है ये दोनों तरफ से जो है ना बराबर से यू हैव टू योर रिस्ट शुड बी वेरी स्ट्रांग टू प्ले डमरू टर 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 ऑल दीज इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड ऑल दीज इंस्ट्रूमेंट आर डूइंग अ ग्रेट ग्रेट वर्क आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट टू डिसरिस्पेक्ट आई एम नॉट डूइंग इट फॉर दैट बट आई एम शोइंग यू that this body can create so much and this body is the instrument and this instrument is instrumental in creating all the instrument from the nature we have been managing exploiting the nature or managing the nature to the best to the worst so there is a big span you know where from where you can pick it and where you can move. But once you get hit by these things, it's difficult to come out of it. So, we have to be near the reality. That's the very, very first thing. And you don't have to create the shortcuts or shortcut realities Shortcut realities or realities in shortcut. So there is always two ways of looking at things. So, aaj to badhai bhai tha, Can you see the how many messages are there? Huh? Are 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 A single alphabet has its identity, but every note or every alphabet need another alphabet to be meaningful. We have our own identity, but to be meaningful, we need another one. So every alphabet need another alphabet to be meaningful, though all the alphabets have their own identity. So with the musical note has beautiful self-identity. But to express something more, they need another musical note to help to enhance. Are, 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 are. Simple, ek hi word. Are, 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 are. अब इसको इसकी vibrations आ रहा है, sound is vibration. When we increase the vibration, are, 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 are. Are 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 nikal gaya are 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 are. Can you think of singing so many ways of aaj 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 are to ab iske andar different ho gaya matlab alag to aaj aaj to aaj to aaj aaj to are do are do are are do are do are aaj to are do are do aaj do are are to zyada expressive ho gaya to ke sath jab dusra word mila to it is more expressive isn't it wana aaj mein bhi aa raha are 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 के साथ कोई सवाल पूछ लो.
थैंक यू पंडित जी फॉर दिस वंडरफुल एक्सप्लेनेशन. वी हैव अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द ऑडियंस. It is from Ram Kumar ji. He has written, Ustad ji namaskar. Aap jab aapko sangeet sunne ka ichcha hoti hai to aap kin gayako ya sangeetkaron ko sunna pasand karte hai? Dusre shabdon mein aapko kaun se gayak sabse adhik pasand hai?
Kisko sunna zyada pasand karte hain? Sabse pehle ek baat sachi baat batau, khud ko nahi sunna pasand karta. क्योंकि जब खुद सुनता हूँ तो मुझे पता नहीं कितनी फॉल्ट्स दिखती रहती. अच्छा सुनने का जहाँ तक ताल्लुक है, आज तो हमारे पास इतनी अच्छी सुविधाएं हो गई हैं, पुरानी पुरानी रिकॉर्डिंग्स हम सुन पाते हैं, तो उसमें हमारे बहुत हमारे पूर्वजों को ही सुनना पसंद करते हैं, जिससे हम अपना अपने इम्प्रूवमेंट और अपने फोकस को इम्प्रूव करते रहें और उनके दृष्टिकोण को हम समझ सकें. और बाहर किस किस को सुनते हैं भैया? बहुत सारे लोगों को. अब रिकॉर्डिंग्स उनकी भी हैं, आमिर खान साहब की रिकॉर्डिंग्स भी सुनते हैं, भीमसेन जोशी जी की भी रिकॉर्डिंग सुनते हैं, बड़े गुलाम अली खान साहब की या विलायत खान साहब की बहुत अच्छी, पंडित निखिल बनर्जी साहब की उनकी भी सुनते हैं. और भाई जो भी रह जाएगा तो फिर आपको लगेगा कि इनकी नहीं सुनते या उनकी नहीं सुनते हैं, पर जो भी अच्छी हैं जो यू गेट हिट बाय दैट पर्टिकुलर राग ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन ऑल्सो. तो इट डिपेंड्स कि मतलब किसका, जैसे जुगलबंदी है शहनाई में विलायत खान साहब की, उस्ताद विलायत खान साहब और उस्ताद बिस्मिल्ला खान साहब की कितनी अच्छी वो है जुगलबंदी गुजरी तोड़ी जो उन्होंने बजाई है. अब पंडित रविशंकर जी के भी मांझ खमाज में उनके भी बहुत अच्छा वो है. अली अकबर खान साहब हैं और पंडित जसराज के भी हैं. इवन प्रेजेंट टाइम में, अभी प्रेजेंट टाइम बोलते भी बड़ा वो लग रहा है, पंडित राजन साजन मिश्रा जी कभी बहुत अच्छा एक और क्रिएट करते थे. राशिद भाई हैं हमारे ग्वालियर घराने के गुरु, वेंकटेश जी भी और हाँ जी एल के पंडित जी भी हैं, मतलब है नहीं भी नहीं वो भी मतलब भी बोल रहा हूँ, उनकी भी रिकॉर्डिंग्स बड़ी अच्छी अच्छी पुराने लेजेंड्स की. वो उनका अप्रोच ही अलग ही था. सब लोग अब हर चीज़ को ब्यूटीफाई करने में लगे हुए, तो ब्यूटी तो उसी में है ही है, ब्यूटीफाई तो करना ही है. संगीत में अगर लताफत नहीं हो, हमारे दादा साहब बोलते थे, वो हमारे दादा के छोटे भाई रहीमुद्दीन खान साहब की मैंने उनकी इंटरव्यू में सुना भाई, वो बहुत अच्छे गवैये थे. तानसेन जी के भी बहुत अच्छे गवैये, या बैजू बावरा बहुत अच्छे थे, बैराम खान साहब बहुत अच्छे थे, और बड़े मोहम्मद खान साहब बहुत अच्छे थे. सबके नाम लेने की बात करें बहुत अच्छे थे, लेकिन जिसने भी एस्थेटिक्स का ध्यान नहीं दिया वो अच्छा गवैया नहीं हो सकता। यू कैन नेवर बी गुड इफ यू डोंट हैव एस्थेटिकल सेंस इन म्यूजिक। एस्थेटिक्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, अ मोस्ट एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ क्रिएशन ऑफ म्यूजिक इज एस्थेटिक्स। यू शुड हैव द एस्थेटिकल सेंस ऑफ where you are singing, what you are singing, where, so you should know, and this can only happen by singing, by practicing, by critically watching your own self. That's the only medium, only way. So I'm listening to many people, even I listen to some film songs. You must be surprised, but there are some fantastic film songs which are in some rags also. So whichever song has got a glimpse of a rag, it remains, it is still there. You still get touched by those rags, that song. They have their beautiful identity, they have beautiful poetry, lyrics are so wonderful. So they are living. Why 100,000 songs have disappeared? Why a few of them are there? You have to think about that. Is it satisfying reply?
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Ustadji. Your reply kind of reflects what you said before of being adaptive. You said you are trying to adapt to the new times, and the fact that you are open to listen to so many artists, and the fact that you're also listening to the perhaps the Bollywood music or the music that you can absorb is really commendable. A couple of things that I definitely want to think back is, you said give time a time. This will be the quote of the day for me, give time a time. I'm going to write that somewhere in my notes and remember it again and again. Thank you so much. Thank you, Pallabhi and Aman, for this absolutely amazing interaction session. We are all sure we can take back a lot from it, and most of our curious questions were answered. Unfortunately, due to time constraints, I would like to say that we could not take a lot of questions from the audience, but be sure we'll come back and there'll be more questions you can answer, ask in future. Spik McKay's vision and the motto to spread Indian culture and to bring youth together is possible only because of the leaders we have, who have dedicated themselves over the years for this cause, for Spik McKay, and encourage us youth to participate and motivate us to keep going. Now, may I request Mrs. Kunda Mahurkar, Chairperson Spik McKay, to address the occasion.
Hello. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you.
Good afternoon in India, and I think good evening in Korea, all right? So it is so nice to have Asifuddin ji with us, giving such beautiful performance and satisfying the questions of all the children. First of all, I would like to thank our chief guest, Mr. Sachin Satpute. He's a chairman of Indian Chamber of Commerce and president of ISRK. Sir, it was a great honor for us to have you for this program. And it was so nice. Your words were so inspirational words for our children. And thank you so much for accepting Spik McKay invitation, Spik McKay Korea chapter invitation to have as a chief guest. It's very great honor to us. Thank you so much, sir. And we would like to have you more and more often and grace the different occasions of Spik McKay Korea chapter whenever they hold the programs, and also help them and support them. That will be my request to you, that we can only grow Korea chapter if we get support from people like you. Pastor Buddhin ji, I always hear you. It was great listening to you. And again, today I enjoyed your performance as well as your question answers were so satisfying to the children. I also thank Indian Embassy for supporting Speakmaking in various ways. I would like to give a little bit this thing to Indian Embassy. If we have this advisory board under the chairmanship of the Ambassador of India in Korea, then we can have more and more support from different people in Korea, and we can make the Korea chapter very strong, and we can have more and more programs in Korea if we get support from the embassy and other people in Korea. Dr. Sonu Trivedi, Director Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center. Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center is always very, very supportive to Speakmaking Korea chapter. When we inaugurated the Korea chapter, that time also their presence was very, very important for the inauguration. And Indian Embassy also had very supportive. We had some people from the embassy, and also ambassador of the Indian ambassador to Korea also was present for that program. And when we inaugurated the Korea chapter, Indian ambassador to Korea was also present that time. So that way they are giving us a lot of support, and then they will keep giving us the support. Also, I would like to thank all the volunteers who took so much trouble in organizing this big program, also inaugural program. And so many, all the volunteers, they have collected so many volunteers. See, volunteers' work is only nishkam seva. They are doing the work without any expectation. That is something very great. Taking out time from their routine work and giving time for some voluntary work. And like Speakmaking is a voluntary movement, and they are giving so much time for that. It is really very, very amazing. And I'm really grateful to them for giving their time to Speakmaking Korea chapter and taking our Indian culture and heritage to Korea. It's very, very important thing for us and for the whole country, Korea, and having good relationship with India and Korea and bringing them close together. And you know, these days, because of the technology, we hum log dur bhi hai, even if we are far, we are close to each other. So this technology has really brought us very close to each other. I don't think we would have met physically if it was the program was to come to Korea, or if you had to come to India. I don't think it was possible. Program would have been there, but we would not have met. See, the advancement of science and technology, we can meet even in different parts of the world. So that is the greatest part that Speakmaking we can have in different parts of the country. And we are having Speakmaking in different parts of the countries because we have volunteers as we have in Korea. See Lailesh, Iqbal, Archana, Shikha, Sushrut, Shweta, Manas, Prashant, Vibhu, Apurva, Pallavi, Safiddin, Naman, and all these volunteers, they work hard day and night to make this program a great success. All Indian committees of Korea, I also like to thank them for supporting this event. And Indian students and researchers in Korea also helped us to make this program successful. And they also participated, and that was a great thing. Even participation also is a great thing. Gradually, when they participate, they get inspired and they also join the movement. So I thank one and all. Thank you, Korea chapter. And the most important person behind this is our Tapasya, who made this chapter. She's reaching every part of the world and opening chapters in different parts of the world. So I would like to give her a big hand and congratulate her for doing this very successfully. Thank you very much. Thank you all Korea chapter, everyone in Korea, and our great Tapasya. Thank you so much. Dr. Seth is also the inspiring factor in this. And because of him, Dr. Seth is the chairman of SpeakMeke, founder of SpeakMeke. And he is the one who is inspiring us always for doing all our work everywhere, all over India, all over the world. Thank you, Korea chapter. Hope to meet you again. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Thank you, ma'am. Your support and encouragement has been one of the instrumental factors why we volunteers feel motivated and inspired to stay connected to the cause. Thank you for providing this platform to us so we can reach out and spread our culture globally. As we are nearing, I would like to ask the audience who has joined us today for the first time to please connect us on our handles, various handles on the various platforms that we have, Facebook, Instagram. Please connect so that you get to know more updates, you get to understand what we're doing, what we're up to. And also, I want to extend a warm thank you and also a request people like Mr. Sachin Satpute-ji to connect more with us. And also, we want to reach out to more such people who want to promote our Indian culture and make further events more successful and perhaps have more and more events. Thank you, Kunda ma'am. As we near the end, I want to also ask Ustadji to kindly speak a few more words about the event today. I know he wanted to say something before and I kind of didn't realize it. Ustadji, could you speak, could you let us know what you wanted to share before?
Yeah, I wanted to just take the name of the accompanist who was with me. This is Salman Varsi. He's a student of Pandit Dalchand Sharma ji, and he's a young Pakhavaj player, and I wish him, you also wish him the best, that we can hear him more and more often. And on my left, it's Arvindan Srinivasan. He's my student, Tanpura. And then this is my nephew, Hurmat Ali Khan. He's an actor, theater actor, but he's acting on Tanpura also today. So he's doing well. And sound has been done by Arman Raza Dehelvi. This is my student, and he's also very good in this, in technician, all these things. And this Ilham Ahmed was also, you know, helping things. But of course, everything, whatever is seen, there's something behind the curtain also. There are seven seen and seven unseen notes, and many things have been manifested because of the unseen things. The musical note which is being sung, there are very supportive, lot of supportive musical notes which helps one note to be sung. So as many as people are working for SpeakMeke, and I congratulate all of you and all the supportive hands, and also the Indian embassy and Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center, and all your and the publicity also. I was not able to pronounce it well. It was researchers and students of South Korea. Yes, and all of you, and Kundaji is always, this ma'am is always always there, and Dr. Said is always listening to what is there, what is happening, and what is
because his message is in between comes and goes. The sound of Tanpura was too loud, so he had just asked to just reduce the sound. I was wondering that what is happening. You must have seen my eyes were going, eyeball was going towards them, but I could not read that message. My sister told me about that. So I congratulate Korea chapter, and I'm sure you're going to excel and you're going to move much forward. And all of, like, the product of Korea is reaching everywhere. I'm sure our culture, they will also accept our culture, our music and things in their different corners of their country, as well as if we can go beyond in Asia Pacific and other places. I congratulate you all of you. Very good tapasya, and I'm just taking your name, but you were connected so much so with me, so this is why I'm just taking your name. And all of you, you good questions, you have put up very nice questions, and the person from the Vivekanand Cultural Center, I say namaste to you also, and to Indian Embassy, and I've forgot the name, so please forgive me for your not taking your name. So thank you for supporting Speak Meke, and be there, be with us forever. Namaskar.
Thank you, Ustadji. Thank you, Ustadji. Means a lot, your words, your encouragement. You have taken us to another world today where we could imagine a happy world. We could all feel more motivated and inspired in these tough times of COVID, where we are away from our families. This kind of feels, the fact that I'm wearing a sari today, I feel more like home. Thank you for giving us this platform. And, you know, we thoroughly enjoyed this. We thoroughly enjoyed your performance. We thoroughly enjoyed connecting with you. As we near the end, may I request Iqbal Qazi, Vice President ISRK and an active volunteer of our Speak Meke Korea chapter, to present the word of thanks.
Thank you, Shweta. Hello, everyone. Namaste and very good evening. It's been, first of all, it's been a very pleasure for me to be part of this auspicious event. And I feel it's honor for me to present a lot of thanks on this wonderful evening of Speak Meke Korea chapter, Mystic Music Series, which organized to spread hope and positivity in these tough times. On behalf of Speak Meke Korea and everyone present here, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to Ustad Wasifuddin Dagarji for his precious time and being available for this event and gracing us with this an amazing experience of Draupad music. And I must say, Ustadji, that the legacy, and everyone here inspired with the legacy which you're carrying for over hundreds of years, and the Dagar Gharana, and the journey of music which you have explained, your philosophy of music which you have explained, interacted and explained to everyone here, is very amazing, and we are very inspired by listening to you. Thank you very much, Ustadji, and I would like to thank all the co-artists who performed with Ustadji today. I would like to thank Mr. Sachin Satputeji, chairman of ICCK, for accepting our invitation and being with us today, and giving a very warm message for Speak Meke Moment in Korea. I would like to thank Kunda Mohorkar ma'am, chairperson of Speak Meke. You have been very phenomenal, and your words have given us a lot of encouragement to take forward this moment in Korea. I extend my heartfelt thanks to Professor Kiran Seth sir, and the national executive team for constant support and providing us with all guidance to organize this event. I would like to extend my thanks to Dr. Sonu Trivedi ji, and we all are very grateful to Embassy of India and Seoul for enormous cooperation for organization in this event. And my special thanks to the Indian students and researchers in Korea for being very exceptional for publicizing this event and coordinating with Speak Meke team to making this event a very successful. My sincere thanks goes to sponsor of this team, because of this is of both Korea and India. Because of this sponsorship, we able to organize this event and have this good message today with having Wasifuddin Dagarji and to spread hope and positivity. I would like to thank all the participants who joined us and all the invitees who joined us today for making this event very very successful. Finally, I would like to say that it's a great feeling for being a part of SpeakMaker and being a part of being a volunteer and being a part of a very motivated and dedicated Korea team, which we are, and being able to organize this event in a very short time, just within 2 weeks, and planning and execution. I don't have words to thank everyone enough of our team members who work with, for their work and for their willingness and their involvement and taking up the responsibilities and making this event very success. I would like to congratulate everyone for our Korea team and also thank all team members, Apurva, Archana, Shikha, Shweta, Pallavi, Naman, Manas, Prashant, Lailesh, Vibhu, and everyone for making this event a very good success and a grand. Before I conclude, I would like to give a message to everyone present here in audience that with SpeakMaker, we are coming with more events. We are coming with more events, many things in coming future. So I'd like to invite you all to join us on, join us with us on our social media networks and support us SpeakMaker movement in Korea by sharing with your friends, families, and especially sharing with your Korean friends and Korean schools and universities about this SpeakMaker movement, about Indian, promoting Indian culture in event. So I would like to thank once again everyone for joining us today. Thank you once again. Namaste.
Thank you, Iqbal. So for people who have just joined us today, I would like to give a little bit background about SpeakMaker. We are the Society for Promotion of Indian Classical Music and Culture Amongst Youth. Our motto is to reach out to larger youth, to make them aware of our culture, to keep our heritage alive. So if you connect with us, if you feel connected to the cause, please spread the message, please spread the word, get more people connected with this cause. And as Indians, we want to promote our culture. So I feel that it is a very noble cause. And at the same time, it is a cause that needs some attention in these hours and these days. So please connect with us on our social media, like Iqbal said, Facebook, Instagram, we are everywhere. So that will keep you posted on our previous event, upcoming events. Thank you for joining us today. Today's event would not have been possible without the support of our volunteers and everybody out there. I'm sure you all wish that Ustadji would keep on performing, but unfortunately all good things have to come to a pause so they can resume again. So please make sure to connect with us, and we are assuring you we'll bring more and more such amazing events to you. And so with that note, me, Shweta, and the entire SpeakMaker team would like to take your leave. Thank you for joining us today, and thank you for making this event a grand success. Stay safe, stay home, be negative, and stay positive. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes,
I just want to interrupt you. At the end, I just want to say big thank you to Vibhu, who has sponsored this program. It was so nice of him because we were not getting, during this COVID time, it was difficult to get the sponsorship. And Vibhu, he came forward and sponsored the program. So I just want to thank him from the bottom of my heart, and he's a very good volunteer. He's always very supportive. Thank you, Vibhu. Keep connected always with us. Thank you very much. Thank you, Korea chapter, and all the volunteers. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Ustadji. Thank you.
Sorry,
thank you, Vibhuji.